Over the last couple of weeks, we've seen more extreme weather conditions across the country, with record-breaking heat in the north and west, persistent smoke haze causing hazardous conditions in the east, and elevated fire weather conditions through many parts. Today, I'm joined by climatologist Lynette Bettio. And Lynn, we know that we've had a positive Indian Ocean dipole and negative southern annular mode influencing our weather patterns of late. We're really waiting for the monsoon. Do you have any good news for us?
Thanks, Andrea. Yes. So we've seen that long-term warming trend over Australia and a drying trend over some parts of southern Australia. And on top of that, we've had one of the strongest positive Indian Ocean dipoles on record this year. That's really been influencing the extreme dry conditions that we've seen in 2019. But the good news is that pattern's starting to break down. So we're starting to see a warming off the coast of Indonesia there. So we should see those conditions start to return to a more normal pattern soon. And so also on top of that, those long-term warm and dry conditions, we've got the southern annular mode, which is still influencing our climate. So it's been unusually persistent this year. So we've seen warming in the atmosphere above Antarctica, and that's really been driving the persistence of this mode. So moving those weather systems further north, which we've seen those wetter conditions off the coast of Tasmania there, but when that air has to come across the continent, we've seen those warmer, drier conditions influencing the fires.
And we've also, of course, with the fires in the landscape, where they are in Queensland and New South Wales, the westerly winds have dragged that smoke towards the coast. So many locations through New South Wales and Queensland have been influenced by hazardous smoke conditions of late. And earlier this week in Sydney, we saw extraordinary conditions with very reduced air quality and reduced visibility as the smoke pooled. And if we take a look at the mean sea level pressure chart for Tuesday, what we can see is we had a trough approaching. We had northeasterly winds ahead of the trough, and then they turned westerly as the trough approached. And with the fires where the locations where they are, just caused all that smoke to pool over the Sydney area. And it wasn't until the trough moved through and we got a southerly wind change that we saw a break. Now, any form of an easterly wind where the winds are coming off the water should bring some relief, but really what we need is rain to put the fires out. If we have a look at the forecast for the weekend and the week ahead, what we can see is there's not a lot of rain on the forecast, possibly some shower and thunderstorm activity in the east there, but not enough to put out fires. And what we are seeing is the heat continuing to build over the north and the west. Darwin's seen an incredible number of days above 35 degrees, and Perth by the end of the weekend is likely to have had 3 days above 40 degrees. And as we look through the weekend and into next week, what we can see is that there's very little rain forecast because we have this huge pool of heat building over the country, with many locations expected to experience several days in a row well above 40 degrees, and really not expecting to see any significant rainfall.
Yeah, it really does speak to that delayed monsoon where we've had that build up of heat across the continent.
And as far as the monsoon goes, what can you tell us about that?
Well, the monsoon is likely to be delayed this year, but as we do go into January, we should start to see some of those wetter conditions, and we should hopefully start to see some of those that moisture drags south as it interacts with those weather systems going through.
So really, hopefully, the monsoon will be what finally breaks the heat. And if we have a look at the rainfall outlook for January to March, very different map to what we've seen in the past.
It is. It's a very neutral looking map, and it really speaks to the breakdown of those drivers that we've seen. So really no strong swings towards wetter or drier conditions over the country. And whilst there's no strong swings towards those above average rainfall, we will of course see rainfall. We will of course see those localised falls, but perhaps not those continuous widespread above average rainfall, which we'd like to see to really break those drought conditions.
So we could see some more localised heavy falls like we saw in Brisbane earlier this week, but unlikely to see the follow-up rain. Less likely to see the follow-up rain. So really, in the short term, it's more heat on the way. We may see the odd shower or thunderstorm around coastal parts, but we're just waiting for that monsoon to hit. So in the meantime, as we head towards the end of the year, please make sure that you're staying up to date with your local forecast and warning information on the Bureau's website and app, and head to your state and territory state departments to get information on heat health and also advice on air quality.